episode 45 of Sketch with Jeff. As always, I'm really excited to see you. You know, summer is coming to an end here in New York City, and I was just looking at my summer sketchbook. You may remember that back in episode 28, I showed you how to make this really cool accordion fold sketchbook. And, well, I filled it up and I'm looking at some of my great memories of the summer. At the beginning of the summer, I thought, maybe this is the year that I do something wild, like climb the tallest mountain, or fly through the sky on a parachute, or even ride a dolphin. But of course, that didn't happen. This was a different kind of summer. It was a little more quiet. As I look back at my summer sketchbook, I realize there are some good memories in here. The summer did have its challenges, but I tried to put really fond memories, things that excited me or things that I was doing, in the sketchbook. I recorded pictures of foods that I ate or wanted to eat, books that I read, places that I went, and of course, I always have to invent new characters. This is going to be a nice memory. Memories are a great reason to keep a sketchbook. What are some other reasons that artists keep sketchbooks? Well, let's look at the Guggenheim Museum and remind ourselves. These images are by the artist Franz Marc. We have a very special edition of one of his sketchbooks in the Guggenheim collection. He was exploring different themes and ideas, maybe things that ended up in his paintings. Sometimes a sketch can be a preparation for a large sculpture. And sometimes sketches can be a way of sharing things, like these sketches that arrived in a letter to one of the old directors of the Guggenheim Museum. And I don't know if these sketches were in a sketchbook, but I love these small drawings by artist Susan Hefuna. Today I'm going to show you how to make an exciting new sketchbook for the fall. And it's going to look a little different than this sketchbook. I'm going to start with some watercolors and some nice thick watercolor paper. But if you don't have watercolors, you can use any colors you have. Crayons, pastels, colored pencils. I'm thinking about fall colors, yellows, oranges, and reds. I'm going to fill my paper with color. And then when I'm done, I'm going to actually fold my paper in half. I'm going to bend it and try to get a nice, straight, even fold. I want it to fold almost like it's a book. Before this started, I actually had printed out a picture of a leaf and cut out the shape of the leaf. I am going to line the edge of the leaf up with the edge of the fold. I want it to touch the edge of the fold, and I'm going to trace it. It's important that I put the leaf right up against the fold because this is going to be the cover of my sketchbook, and I want it to be at the fold so I can open it like a book. Next, I'm going to get some thin pieces of paper, just some regular, ordinary paper. I have about 3 sheets here, and I'm folding them in half. After they are folded, I'm going to tuck them inside my folded piece of watercolor paper, line them up so they're right there in the middle, and they need to be against the fold too, so I can cut out everything together. I'm using some sharp scissors. Make sure you're doing this very safely. If you're a child, make sure you have an adult helping you cut. You can use the sharp scissors to go around the outside of your leaf. I like to cut little pieces off at a time, going slowly around the parts of the leaf so that I can get everything cut out the way I want it to. Take your time, do it safely, and if you need to do a simpler leaf, that's fine. Mine's a little bit complicated. Now when I open it up, wow, it's a book. And that's because I didn't cut the edge near the fold. I let it go and bend around to the back cover, and I didn't cut that part of the leaf off. So now, just by stapling it in the middle and making sure it's secure, I have a book. I'm going to add a nice title to it, first in pencil, and then I'll trace over it with Sharpie. And that way I can really be proud of this sketchbook and look forward to carrying it around with me during the fall and putting my ideas down on paper. A staple or two right in the middle will hold it all together. And because I didn't cut the edge where the fold was, I've got a book that hopefully will last a while and will bring me a lot of great memories from the fall. My friend Pencil loves to draw. I wonder what Pencil would put in a new fall sketchbook. Pencil, what do you think?
I would draw leaves because I love leaves in fall because they change colors in fall.
Pencil always has great ideas for things to draw. I wonder what you would put in a new fall sketchbook. You could draw imaginary things, or you could draw things that you observe and see in the world around you, or you could do a combination of both. In fact, that's my challenge for you this week. It's to make a new fall sketchbook. Yours could look like this, or it could be a little more simple. You could just take some paper and fold it together, staple it or tape it, put your name on it, and get ready for some great drawing challenges in the fall. I can't wait to see what you make. Anytime you make something, be sure to share it with us. Share it at Guggenheim using the hashtag SketchWithJeff. I love seeing your art. As we move into the fall here in New York City, and schools are starting to open again, and museums like the Guggenheim are reopening, we're going to switch to once a week episodes of Sketch with Jeff. So be sure to check back every week for new episodes. I have lots of great ideas of ways to sketch and draw that I'm excited to share with you. I have to say I love autumn in New York City. I can't wait to see the colors of the leaves change and look around and see all that is happening outside. I'm gonna have my sketchbook with me always. In fact, I hope that my sketchbook never leaves my side. Sorry, I had to say it. I hope to see you soon. Bye.